Is there gonna be any skits that we usually do in this review?
Nope.
Why? Because we got absolutely nothing right now. Why?
Well, because, one, we don't know anybody who is a stalker right here and is strange right now. And two, we want this review done since it's sunset outside. I mean, yeah, sunset outside. That we need to get this done now.
Why?
Because that's why we are in a rush.
I'm okay then, but whatever, I guess. So, how was Oswald, huh?
Little man Shanahan, one, I know he's in the movie, but why can't I be in the movie? Because no one cares about you anymore, because they would make you look like a hopeless fucking sad out.
True, but still, whatever it is, I don't care. We're just gonna talk about this later. Well, I gotta start reviewing the movie then.
Oh, okay then. Fine, whatever.
Okay, it's time for me to start this review. Okay, if anybody asks right now why it's sunset right now, because there were so many people in the theaters that we had to watch this movie around afternoon, just for that. And anyway, so in order for me to start the review, we gotta talk about the first movie. What do I think about the first movie? Good, that's it. I really got nothing to say. It's an acid trip because of the mad visual effects used in this movie, trying to make it look optical illusions, what it is. So anyways, that's enough about that. Although I did not really see the other ones, like WandaVision, Moon Knight. I don't know why I mentioned Moon Knight, even though I do. I think WandaVision is one of them, hopefully a main part piece. Also, What If?
Why did I say that?
I'll explain why later. Well, anyways, and other stuff. So, and anyways, that's basically it for the first review. But anyways, let's actually talk about the second movie, Multiverse of Madness. So anyways, here's my review of Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness 2.
Little story! Seems a little bit normal, huh?
Weird. This is one hell of a movie. Why? Let me tell you. What is the story for Doctor Strange 2? Well, here's my notes. Doctor Strange isn't going through a lot. It's not going through a lot right now, like some marriage or something. And then after that, we also got the one girl that we kind of saw in the beginning of the movie, like, because the first 5 minutes we were like, what the hell is going on? Well, we'll explain that later. But anyways, they meet the girl, which is from, actually her name is called American Chavez. That's what it is. And then she is the one that goes all around all the multiverses. And then after that, she does everything, she deals with it, and then blah blah blah, all this stuff happens. And then after that, Scarlet Witch from Sergeant said, Astro, aka Wanda, from WandaVision, because I don't know. And then Scarlet Witch said, I want to see my children, so I'm going to go into that multiverse and try to take over the world. Okay, not really, but still. And then there's also other stuff that happens, like blah blah blah. They did went to a universe after they went through a battle with Wonji. The guy that appeared in the post credits from the Shang-Chi movie, which no, they did not appear. No, Shang-Chi's not in the movie. So no sequel, I guess. Whatever. There's also the other stuff I would say that. Yeah, they go through the one and it looks like futuristic, like this is a society would look like if Thanos did win Infinity Stones or whatever. This is what society would look like if whatever, I don't know. But anyways, for those of the dude that the one guy, I'm pretty sure he was in the first movie, but I kind of forgot because even though I saw that yesterday at the time of recording this. Well, whatever. There's also other stuff I would say, but featuring some cameos. I'm not saying them yet. We're gonna wait till the character. When I get to the characters, I'll tell you who they are. And anyways, and then there's doing other stuff and blah blah blah, and then other stuff happens, and then after that, they basically show the evil Doctor Strange. Sure, he's from the. It's not. I don't know if it's the What If one or the villain, but it's not the villain because this was Scarlet Witch. But whatever. And then other stuff happens and blah blah blah. Yeah, I think that's basically the premise. I don't feel like explaining the whole thing. Well, anyways, what are my thoughts on the story?
Complex.
This story is kind of complex when you first saw. When you first look through the like. Okay, is this gonna be like? Yeah, I get it. It's. I think for sure this happens after Spider-Verse. I mean, Spider-Verse, No Way Home. Well, and you already saw that review, so that's because that kind of connects to the multiverse thing. Even though the sneak peek of the Doctor Strange movie wasn't all the way in the end, even though I usually do not like saying it all the way in the credits, although they only did twice. Ghostbusters 2016, yes, I did see that movie, the whole thing, there was an after credit scene, and then Jackass Forever, which basically nobody left in the credits. That's not a review. I'm not doing 4.5, okay? Thanks, and really, just do the... Probably make that like a separate review video. Anyways, there's also other stuff I would say. I don't think there's really that much. Compared to the Batman, it was like none. It really has like one or something. But whatever. There's also other stuff I really could see. Most of them, I would say... it's complex, but you couldn't. After you see the first, and my arm just came off again. I had that fixed on the last review. No, I think it was that one right there. Come on, I just fixed it in the bag, guys, and now this happened again. Well, whatever, I'll fix it. And then overall, I would also say it's really nothing for me to say because it's kind of complex. But does it make it bad? No. Once you learn, mostly the slower you see this, you'll slowly get used to it. But I want to question you all, what are the multiverses they see? There's only one. So, not including the montage where they, when you see different kinds of multiverses, that only happens once, and then they never watch it, and I never mention it again. But whatever, overall, there's really not that much. It was just a scientific one, that's really it. And then there's also the thing from the dream sequence from the beginning. Now when it came back. But also, the postcard scene, let's talk about that one. I don't even know who that person is, but after the... Oh yeah, I think we'll talk about one thing for the end. And my arm just came off. Great. Now I'm a missing arm. Great. I should be missing hand. That's what I'm gonna... I still have the arm. But whatever. There's also, trying to steal this... try to meet somebody, and then after that, oh yeah, he has a third eye now. The book I wasn't mostly important in the movie, but overall, there's really nothing important. I'm pretty sure it's hitting Doctor Strange 3, but whatever. And then there's also another thing, the guy that punches himself. Hey, it stopped! Yay! Alright, it went on. You were expecting, how much cameos are there? Only 5. I'll explain more, but overall, the story here is complex, but once you get used to it kind of makes it good, just to say the least. We'll get my arm fixed for this. Alexis, I got the tape for you to fix your arm, and here you go. So, anyways, let's continue on. The visual effects, huh? So far, it's looking normal. And I have rainbows. I had the rainbow effect on my mouth right now. Oh, ha! We'll figure it out later. Anyways, what are my thoughts on the visual effects? I feel like I am high on LSD because of the visual effects. Why? First movie was trippy. Now this one amplified to another level. Especially on the part when, American Chavez and Doctor Strange got into the multiverse, and also the traveled so much to the disease, which kind of shows how the visual effects was great. And his fate is went through a lot of us. Would have been the first time he went through No Way Home and the first movie, and now I don't think he went through Infinity War, not Endgame, because he didn't hear it until the end. So anyways, why the has he in a wipe? And then, anyways, these also one of the other things that I would say is, I honestly don't know how to explain it since the visual effects are so damn amazing, especially with the action scenes. And let's talk about Twitter's face right now. PG-13. Why? Let me explain. Gore. Same Raimi, what the fuck? I know there's kind of like horror elements in this movie, but like jump scare, there wasn't like a jump scare. I don't know, one of them that scared the fuck out of me. It was when there's the claws right there, and then Scarlet just appeared out of just came out of it, and that just scared me for some fucking reason. I don't like no fucking why. And then because I don't know, but and there's also other stuff I would say. Let's talk about the Exorcist. Anyways, the Exorcist is good, but why is it so grim? Good blood, actual blood. Why we see blood? Cause the alien, the weird one-eyed alien. We saw the eye. He got stabbed in the eye, but he also got it yanked out. You got his eye yanked out. Kind of like Johnny Knoxville, then he went through with his eye, right? Yeah. Well, that seems fucking wrong. You know, I have not seen Action Point. Anyways, other stuff I would say, your other gores was one, sort of, which came out of nowhere. We were trying to defeat all the Ultrons. They made a shield. So does this mean we're getting Aegis of Shield? No, they did not appear in the movie. We got Ultrons, though. I don't know why Ultrons, but... And what happened to the Avengers 2, the second Avengers movie, huh? Honestly, I don't know. I am not seeing the movie. Whatever. There's also the other scenes where other blood stuff, where because all the stuff kind of feels like the mom from the Mitchells and the Machines. Yeah, anybody know that? Anyways, there's also other scenes when the Doctor Strange and the Spear Strange, is that what his name from the with Christine, and then there's also the one with the one we were finding with Music Notes, and then after that the spirit train fell off of this thing and then got impaled to the limb, and they do show that. Although there's other stuff which went one from the cameos, which I do not wait until they get to the characters and we'll talk about who they are, but they all died except for the green guy. Well, so one of them got his head struck out right there, and then the second one got the one that was slowly disappearing, but his head just got yanked. And then the third one was I don't even know. I'm pretty sure the third one was five. Yeah, I think it was five. So three. The third one was probably the one that they had a shield. That's kind of it. And then it somehow got sliced up in half. They don't show it. They don't show like that right there, but they don't show it in when it happened, because that would be like an R right there. But that's the one way to kill somebody off. Although, what if that happened? Whatever, the fourth one, which fell off of the statue. That's why. Like a Game Beast 50 drop kick. And that was. And I love these notifications appeared out of nowhere, probably because I don't know what's going on. But anyways, I'm moving on from that. And that's really it. I got nothing much to say besides the visual effects was great, but mostly the action scenes kind of took it off because of the amount of people. Oh yeah, the sixth one. They slapped something in these necks. Scarlet was snapped their neck off while he was on a walking wheelchair. Yeah, you obviously know. But anyways, overall, I really got nothing else to say for the visual effects. It's really great, but the action is kind of called it out with the blood for PG-13. Welcome back to the 80s, where PG-13 actually meant something. Where mostly he like the movie Red Dawn, which was the first one, or Gremlins, or the Temple of Doom, which is the two movies that basically were the reason why we have that rating today. Although. Yeah, I honestly, whatever. Anyways, yeah, also other stuff that I really got nothing else to say, but overall, I just say that the visual effects are great, especially the action from a PG-13 gore. And I love it because of it. You know, this is kind of weird. We have no special guest today, huh? Weird. You know, that happens a few times, but okay. The characters. Does this mean we're going to talk about the cameos? Whoa, let's talk about Deadpool, you see? He's not in the movie. Damn it! At least we got a sneak peek of what's that called movie on Fantastic Four? Why? Let me tell you why. What are my thoughts on the characters? But we're gonna talk about the characters later. Let's address the cameos first. Three of them I'm pretty sure were from What If. One of them I'm pretty sure obviously was the Captain or from the one with the Britain's version of Captain America. And then the other one was I'm pretty sure was TikTok from. Pretty sure they said people said it was Inhumans or something. I don't even know. And they also the Captain Marvel, the other, not the Captain Marvel that we have, but the Captain Marvel with an African American. Also, So remember what I said about the island from Dead Silence? Let me explain. We also have a secret the character we see from them, but who? It's Elastic or whatever the hell, Mr. Fantastic. We finally got to see Fantastic Four. You, I know most people are already. I always said, "Oh my god!" And that's it. There really not that many people ever saw that. It's like, wait, that's it. That's yeah. And after that, we also got Professor X from the X-Men, and I was like, "Oh yeah, I knew it. I knew." The X from No Way Home when Venom was in there, even though Venom wasn't really shown, he was just the guy. But from Venom gonna be Carnage, I haven't seen it because I do not fucking care. But anyways, I knew that X, that show the X was from Professor X. I fucking called it, and now you're gonna suck. You're gonna suck at everything for saying that I did. Okay, no one commented, but still, whatever. Anyways, yeah. All right. Anyways, enough of the cameos. And now you know which one of them died. The Horn King or whatever his name was the one that got hit, that got his head exploded from there, and the Elastic Fantastic Four guy got disintegrated, but his head just like popped out. The Captain, the Britain one, the British Captain America's sliced her up in half. But you know, still don't show. And Captain Marvel just fell from the statue. Eh. I don't even know the rest about, but. Okay. There's also other stuff, but let's talk about the main ones. Captain Strange. Eh, still sad. There's really nothing new about him anymore. I really gotta get him in the past with that, but eh, it's fine. Let's talk about the only one, American Chavez. I was so close to forgetting her name. I find her pointless, but I thought she was pointless when I first saw her in the beginning, but later, she kind of needed, because one, she's the one who can actually go through all the multiverses, and she doesn't get mad, but she can because she can't control her powers. Spoiler alert, she can. Why? Well, because of Scarlet Witch, duh. And then there's also Scarlet Witch. This is probably the most, she's a fucking psychopath. Why? When she was with the Ultrons, destroying all the Ultrons, it feels like she just sliced somebody up and sliced their heads off, and they don't even show it. I'm pretty sure Ryan Reynolds would have been proud of that. But whatever. She's fine. She's a great villain, but later, she's kind of point. Doesn't really need it after WandaVision happened, even though I've not even seen it. Because one, I don't have time anymore because I have this, I have like three channels now. Actually two, because this one doesn't really count. I just have that because, I'm gonna get taken down here. Anyways, other stuff that I would say, I guess you don't know, but whatever. The other characters are also there, but, they're fine. The guy from that I saw in that post credits, I still can't not know his name, but I really don't see what his name is. I don't know, I can't even confusing him with Banshee from the movie, even though he was in the post credits. So you know that. I don't know if it's Eternal Tournaments or something. I don't know if it's Eternal, but whatever. And then we had the main villain, also part of, Christine, that's her name, okay. She's actually useful compared to the first movie. This first one, she really didn't do that much besides I'm trying to save Dr. Strange after getting stabbed by an ice. And also going through with that girl. You know, also fun fact, American Chavez actually has two moms. Why? I don't know, the internet went apeshit over that, I don't know why. But moving on from that, because I really got nothing else to say, and it's kind of like, it's night outside, but whatever. Overall, I really got nothing else much to say here, but most of the characters are good, but I don't know, it's kind of the same I would usually see, but just for me at least, I don't even know what I'm explaining most of them. Seriously, it's just American Chavez, don't find it interesting at all. I don't know. Overall, I really got nothing to say anymore. Overall, I'd say the characters mostly good, but I'm pretty sure some improvements, some there are there. Characters are just there because Yeah, that's basically what everyone was talking about. Honestly, the most important key in the movie, they're gonna have cameos. I mean, those are the only ones they have. Only six people. Six people. That's it. Nobody else. No, you respecting Andrew? Nope. Deadpool? Nope. Everything? No. Wolverine? Nope. Yeah. Everyone else? Nope. Yeah, that's it. Nothing else. Whatever. Stan Cheap? Nope. Eternals? Nope. Anybody? Nope. And that's it. Really nothing else. Overall, that cameos are just only six. That's it. It's just from What If? The guy from Fantastic Four, which we'll probably see later in a couple decade. And then there's also Professor X, and that's it. That's it. Nobody else. Respecting Wolverine? Nope. Everybody else? Nope. Just letting you know that. Well, anyways, whatever. There's also, yeah, overall, I really got nothing else to say. Overall, the characters are good, but whatever. I honestly got nothing for me to say, honestly. All the quietness above. It is so weird like this. Well, anyways, overall, let's have a normal review for once. Yeah, that's nice. Besides the arm, but then feels back to a regular review. I like this more. Should I start doing this more often, huh? Yeah. I don't know why I'm doing that, but okay. Wait until it gets his order or something, I don't know. Anyways, overall, I really have nothing else to say because Doctor Strange 2 Multiverse of Madness is good. It's much better than the first movie, just saying. Let you know that. Is it better than the first? Yes, but I was like, story is kind of complex, but you'll soon, like, later on, you'll understand why. But the visual effects are obviously amazing. I haven't said that in a while, even though I mostly do not like saying that. You would already really get any amazing visual effects anyway, because most of them are garbage. Especially Dr. Strange's zombie version. It looks terrible for me, because it kind of looks cheap. The way they put the face on kind of looks like a mask, but whatever. Suddenly, my mind is singing the dream song. Ew! Whatever. And there's also, overall, the characters are good, but the characters are good, but I'm just sure the cameos are just pointless there because, one, they get killed off anyways, but yeah, so just stand there, and basically that's it. Most of the ones you kind of wanted are not even in it. Especially in the post credits. After credit, all the way to the end, nothing. Even though I don't really stay in the end. I just have to look up Wikipedia for that. And then also other reviewers. But whatever. What's my recommendation? I'm just sure. If you see Spider-Man No Way Home, then yeah, you'll be fine with it. Unless you see the first. If you want to watch a recap, I'll watch the first one first. Not Spider-Man, because one, it's not on Disney Plus, even though. It's mostly never gonna happen for another five years. Unless we have it on, unless I watch on Amazon Prime, but maybe that'll work. But now, yeah, there's really other stuff. And there's also, like, other shits, but I do not fucking care about that, because, one, I do not care. I just wanna watch the movies, because they kinda connect. No, they just have to, like, just do their own, TV version of the cinematic or whatever. Anyways, overall, what else am I rating? I would say, okay, that's kinda hard between a 7 or an 8, but I would say at least a 7, because one, the cameo, there's not that many cameos, even though they kind of promised about it, but it was kind of complicated because most of the characters are just, then the multiverse is just, yeah, that was just not that many. There was only one. I know they went through a whole compilation, but they kind of just go include them more often. Probably that would work. Well, whatever. Anyway, yeah, that's really, yeah, I got for real. Yeah, that's basically just normal. And it's night outside, huh? Just like we always do with these reviews, we always do them at night. So, Mickey, how is your Roger Rabbit sequel going? I don't know. I don't think it's good. I don't think it will be a great Roger Rabbit sequel, even though they are doing it. But whatever. I think they can do it. You sure? Yep. Space Jam did it. It wasn't good. Exactly. It's probably gonna be just like Space Jam. Okay, you know, it's kind of glad that we finally got a normal review here. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, so it's my arm coming off again, like last time. I think everything worked out great. Yeah, same thing. Yep. Now let's just relax. Ah, you're a good thing. Yep.